Hi everyone, I just harvested not too long ago 10 absolutely beautiful butternut squash. And a lot of people have been asking for garden to table recipes. So today we're making a very quick, simple butternut squash rice recipe. So we're gonna harvest a couple things right from the garden and then cook it and eat it right in the garden. So I've got my butternut squash ready. Now I need to grab an onion. See, it's around here on this side, growing in a Smart Pots container here. And I just planted these onions here at the base of my eggplant, and these are ready to harvest and are going to be absolutely delicious to flavor my butternut squash rice. Now we just need some basil and we are good to go. Nothing like grocery shopping from your own backyard. Can't get more fresh or more local than that, right? Well, here I've got some absolutely beautiful Parisian basil growing here in my late summer garden. So this is an absolutely tasty, very mild tasting sweet basil. Just gonna clip it right off. It's absolutely beautiful. And we have been totally enjoying how this basil tastes in different recipes and salads. We're gonna grab some for our butternut squash rice today. Oh, it's gonna be so tasty. Wait till you guys taste this dish. It's so delicious. Okay, that should be plenty. Well, just washing the vegetables we need for the recipe. Now this recipe is so delicious. It comes together very quickly, and today we brought the kitchen to the backyard. So let me just tell you the simple ingredients that you're gonna need. First off, of course, you're gonna need the star of the show, some butternut squash. Any kind of basil you might have growing in your garden, any kind of onion you might have growing in your garden, green onions, red onions, your white onions, it really doesn't matter. And I'm also bringing in some fresh, garden fresh garlic. Absolutely delicious, adds so much flavor to your recipe. You're gonna need about 2 cups of rice. I'm using brown rice, already cooked, and some very simple seasonings. You'll need some olive oil, some fresh ground pepper, some sea salt, and some cumin. That's it. Now, first of all, you're gonna need to pre-cook your butternut squash. I actually cooked this in the crock pot, and my crock pot cooked this butternut squash in about 2 hours, or you can bake it in the oven at 425 for about an hour to an hour and a half. Now, you do not want your butternut squash to be cooked to where it's super mushy, to where you can mash it. You want this to be kind of firm so that when you poke it with a fork, it has a little bit of give to it and it's not super mushy. Okay, first we're going to prepare our ingredients. We're gonna chop up our onion and our basil and cube up our butternut squash. These fresh garden vegetables smell absolutely delicious. I wish you guys could be here to smell it. Now I am gonna save the onion top as well, because we're also gonna use that in the recipe. So I'm just gonna give this onion a fine chop here.
Ooh, my eyes are watering.
Onions will do that. Peel it. Chop it up as finely or as coarsely as you like. Actually, let's chop up this onion top too, because it's going to add a nice bright color to our rice dish. Take off the little brown spots. Get those out of the way. Slice up this onion top. You can eat that too. We don't want to waste any of our garden fresh vegetables that we can eat. Okay, now let's chop up our basil. Oh, this smells so good. I'm just gonna take the leaves off of the basil, off of the stems. And we're gonna give this basil a nice rough chop. And what I always like to do as I cook is keep a little bowl on the side here where I can put my parts I'm not using, because those will go right into the compost pile. Next, we're going to cube up our cooked butternut squash. Now, I do love cooking it whole. It's just so much easier than trying to slice it when it's raw, because the skin is super tough. Now, look how easy that cuts now that it's cooked. So we'll just cut the butternut squash in half. And we're gonna save these seeds, just scoop them out and save them for roasting. Oh look, this one sprouted. Look at that, little seed sprouted inside the butternut squash. That's kind of cool. So we'll just scoop these out. Just get in there and scoop it out. Get all that mush out of there. This squash, the most beautiful color. Look at that. There's another one sprouted in there. It's kind of fun. Oh, this is so pretty. I love the color of butternut squash. It's so tasty. Now what I'm going to do is peel it. So just take a smaller knife and just peel it, leaving as much of the meat as possible. The peeling comes off so easy once it's cooked. So I've got my butternut squash all peeled. Again, we're gonna set the peelings aside for the compost pile, and we're just gonna cut our butternut squash into about 1-inch cubes. And you can see the butternut squash is nice and firm. It's not too mushy, so it cuts very nicely into cubes. Now I'm gonna preheat my skillet here. Actually, it's been on while I've been chopping, so it's actually been preheating. Pour about a tablespoon or so of olive oil into the skillet. And kind of swirl it around in there. You want to hear that sizzle when you pour those onions in, because that's what we're going to saute first. Pour in the onions. There we go. There's that sizzle I love. I'm going to saute the onions for about a minute or so just to soften them up a bit. Oh, it smells so good. Camera guy, can you smell it?
Yeah, I can.
Oh, man.
I'm starting to get hungry.
I think our neighbors are going to want to come over and try some of this. I'm going to turn this down just a bit. You want it to be kind of a medium hot skillet. And once the onions are sauteed and softened, we're going to add in a couple of these garlic cloves. Now, this is where it gets really fun. Add however much garlic you like. We tend to prefer kind of a medium garlic flavor. So these are my small little garlic cloves that I grew last year, but man, are they tasty. Now, if you don't have a garlic mincer, this is one of the handiest kitchen tools I have. It is just so, so handy. Just put the garlic in there and then push this down. And look at that. It just minces it really nicely. You don't even have to peel the stuff. Now, I put the garlic in kind of towards the end of the saute of the onions because you don't want the garlic to burn. That makes it a little bit bitter. Oh my goodness.
Oh my gosh, that smells so good.
Does that not smell absolutely amazing?
We haven't had breakfast yet.
I know. Okay, my onions and my garlic are finished sauteing. Oh, absolutely heavenly. Next, I'm going to add my 2 cups of cooked brown rice and heat that through. And I like to prepare all the ingredients the day before, or even just use ingredients that I have left over. This rice was actually left over from another recipe. So just stir it around. And if things start to stick in your pan like they are in mine, just add a little bit more olive oil. The nice thing about this recipe is you can really customize it to your taste. You can use quinoa, you can use risotto, whatever type of grain that you like. I'm gonna season my rice with a little bit of cumin. And again, use whatever spices you like. We absolutely love cumin. I'm just gonna sprinkle some into taste. It's probably gonna be about 1/2 teaspoon or so. Just stir that around until the rice is all the way heated through.
That is smelling good.
Oh, that cumin just really kicks it up a notch. It'd also be good with maybe some chili powder, some red pepper flakes, whatever your heart desires. Now, here's the fun part, the star of the show, the butternut squash. Gotta love it. Oh, hear that sizzle. I'm gonna very gently stir this around so I don't split apart the butternut squash cubes until it's heated through. Look at that color. Oh, that's fabulous. You know what? I just thought of something. I'm going to grab a little sprig of rosemary right over here because I think rosemary would be absolutely delicious in this recipe too. So while that's heating through, I'm just going to grab some. Oh, this smells so good. Oh, fabulous. Gonna run over the hose and wash it, and we're gonna throw some rosemary in too. Oh, love this. What a combination this is gonna be. And again, you can't get any more fresher, any more local than your own backyard. True garden to table cooking. So I am just going to strip the rosemary off this little sprig here. Very easy to do. I'm not even gonna bother chopping it. This is a really soft stem. So the rosemary is nice and soft. It's gonna be delicious in this recipe. Oh my gosh, we just kicked this up another notch. You smell it, camera guy?
Yes.
Whoa, rosemary and cumin, butternut squash and rice, garden fresh onions. Oh, this is absolutely amazing.
And all of this just was in the backyard.
It was all in the backyard.
Incredible. And the taste is just so much better than store-bought.
So flavorful. I don't even think you could find anything that has this kind of flavor, even at an organic farmer's market. So this is amazing. So much fun to grow it right in your own backyard. And I think I've got all my ingredients put in. Oh yes, a little bit of fresh ground pepper. And the fresh ground, gotta have the fresh ground. Makes all the difference in the flavor. A little bit of that to top it off. And we're gonna put a little pinch of sea salt. Now again, I'm not going by exact measurements here, so you really just have to do it to taste. It's probably a little too much salt. It's okay, isn't it supposed to be good luck if you throw salt over your shoulder or something?
Go for it.
There we go.
Nice.
Okay, I think we are ready to plate this up. And oh my gosh, look at this. This is incredible. Now this is really nice paired with salmon. I made it with some barbecue salmon last week. I made this up as a side dish. Oh my gosh, look at that color.
Wow.
Absolutely gorgeous. Camera guy, you're gonna have to come around here and give this a taste test with me. This is so good. One very important ingredient I forgot to add on top, the fresh basil. And I like to sprinkle this on top rather than cook it, because it just has so much more flavor if you do it right at the end. Oh my gosh. Should I add a little bit more?
Whatever you think. This is looking so good.
Oh, this is looking so, so good. Fork for you, fork for me.
Right from the
back. Oh my gosh, look
at
that.
Right from the backyard.
Mmm. Wow.
That is so good.
The butternut squash.
Wow.
The basil, the onion, the cumin, the garlic,
right,
all coming
from
together.
The backyard. This never even went into the house. We brought the kitchen out here today. This is why we do it.
This is why we do it, guys.
Easy song.
Doesn't have to be complicated to cook garden to table.
That's real good.
So simple. Took us, what, maybe 15 minutes?
Mm-hmm.
So, guys, comment below. Let me know if you're going to try this recipe. If you've got butternut squash growing. If you've got, you can either do it with zucchini, you could do it with spaghetti squash, acorn squash, whatever you have growing in your garden, just use this as a starting point. Comment below, let me know how you're going to customize it. Make sure you subscribe. Hit that bell icon for notifications of my videos. We're going to be doing a lot more garden to table ahead. All right, guys, thanks a lot for watching. We'll see you on the next video.